So in this video, I will be explaining you how to perform the compressive strength of cement mortar. So for this, the apparatus required is cement, which is sieved through 90 micron sieve. Then we have sand, and we have the compressive strength mould. So this is the mould which is used for determining compressive strength of cement mortar. Okay, the size of this mould will be 7 cm by 7 cm by 7 cm. It's a cube mould, which means the all the three dimensions of this cube will be 7 cm. So precisely around 7.06 cm. So this is the mould which we use generally for performing compressive strength test on cement mortar. And we require a measuring jar to measure the water quantity required, and trowels for mixing, and as usual a weighing balance. So first, how shall we start the experiment is, we need to determine the materials required for the mortar mould. Always remember, we perform or we generally cast three moulds to determine the compressive strength, whether it could be 1 day, 3 days or 7 days or 28 days, how many days it may be. First we have to cast at least minimum 3 cubes. Minimum 3 cubes are required. And when we determine the compressive strength, we take the average of these 3 cubes what you get. Okay, so minimum number is 3. Today I will be showing you how to cast the mould. Okay, so when you do it, you have to do minimum 3 samples. So I will be showing you how to calculate the values or how much quantity of cement and sand we should take. So for 1 cube mould, first we have to take cement as 200 grams and we follow the IS code IS 4031 part 6. So according to that, weight of the cement per mould will be around 200 grams and weight of the sand will be 600. Why? Because the proportion, mix proportion, is 1:3. So for 1 part of cement we take 3 parts of sand. So 200 into 3 is 600. Then what is the combined weight of cement and sand now? What is the combined weight of the binder? It is 200 plus 600, which is 800 grams. So percentage of water required is very much important to us, and percentage of water required for mixing will be again dependent on the consistency of the cement. So we have already done consistency and we got 29.5%. So the consistency of or the percentage of water required is given by the formula P/4+3 percentage of total weight of the binder. So P is 29.5, which is the consistency of cement, by 4 plus 3 into what is the total weight of the binder? 200 plus 600, 800, since it's a percentage, by 100. So this calculation came out to be 83 ml. So for one standard mortar cube mould, we have 200 grams of cement, 600 grams of sand and 83 ml of water if your consistency is 29.5. otherwise you have to take this formula and calculate. So now I have measured 200 grams. I'll measure 200 grams of cement, 600 grams of sand and 83 ml, and I'll show you the mixing process. So in previous videos I have already shown you how to take the weight. So you put the weight of the empty pan, you press the air button so the pan weight becomes zero, then you add the material, you'll get the weight of the material. So this is the 200 grams of cement which is sieved through 90 micron. This is 600 grams of sand and we have 83 ml of water. As I have shown you the calculation how to get this 83 ml. So now we will do the mixing of the mortar. Okay. So mix cement and sand first in a dry form uniformly. You can observe this is a uniform mix. Now you try to add the 83 ml of water into this. Okay. Fill the cement mortar into the mould. So first fill 1/3 of the mould and then compact it for 25 with the 25 times with the help of the damping rod. So once you finish the 25 times stamping evenly, then fill again the next 1/3 layer. Like that, finish the complete filling of the mold and level the surface. So after filling the mold, trim the extra portion and level off the surface. So this is the complete filling of the mold. So you have seen the process. So after one day, we demold it and you take out the specimen, which is your mortar cube, and then you put it in the curing tank for curing. So at which age of mold you want to calculate the strength, after that after that particular age of curing, just take out the mold and before putting it in the compressive testing machine, just leave it for half an hour or so. Let the surface of the sample become dry since you are taking it out from water. Then you place the specimen in the compressive strength to determine the compressive strength. So now this will go for curing after complete setting. So after 24 hours or so, you can just demold it and put it in the curing tank. So this is how the mold looks once you take out from the curing. Okay, so I have taken out the sample after 7 days of curing, and this now specimen will now go into the compressive testing machine to determine the strength. And remember, we will not take the strength of only one mold or one specimen or one cube. We have to take 3 and we have to take the average of it. So that will be the average compressive strength. So this is for 7 days I'm doing, but you have to do for 7 days and 28 days also. So generally we do for 28 days to determine the grade of the cement. Okay. So now I'm placing this in the compressive testing machine. So after placing in the compressive testing machine, we will apply the load and we will see at which load the specimen will fail. Falling on the specimen, you can see the reading. So the machine will stop automatically once the specimen will fail. So the specimen failed, and here you can note the strength. So yeah, we can note the load, and after getting the load, we have to calculate the compressive strength. So the load, you have to check for the red color needle. So this is around 80 kilonewton. Okay, so 80 kilonewton is the load, compressive load. So this load by area of the specimen will give you the compressive strength.